Rwandan coffee.
Rwandan coffee.
Hey on why.
Drove his cycles. So we're at Drover's Cycles in Hay-on-Wye. Malcolm, myself, and we've just asked these guys if we can park up the car just for the night, and they've been good enough to say yes. So that's pretty cool. So we've got a car parking space, or Malcolm has.
Enjoying quality time with the White Explorer.
Yeah,
good stuff.
And the Wanderer. The Wandering Wolf. Good stuff. In the places we like.
Oh yes.
Indeed. Drover's Cycles, Hay on Wye. Good little business. There you go. Oh, is that nice, Mark?
Beautiful.
It is.
Really nice coffee.
I love it, man.
Oh yeah. Proper hiking brew, that. You won't sleep tonight now.
This will give me a vibe.
Too much caffeine.
Cheers to you, Malcolm.
Cheers, Matt.
Nice one, mate. Of course, we don't drink, do we?
No.
This is our...
this is our beverage.
This is our beverage.
Irish coffee.
Mm, that is nice. Tastes fruity.
It's nice, isn't it?
Doesn't it?
Yeah, it's really nice.
Real fruity.
Very nice.
And that's nice coffee. That's really good. Check out the profile of this machine. Yeah.
South African, that one?
That's from South Africa.
That's from South Africa.
Serious, man. How much would that set you back, mate? Couple of pennies, probably 2,500, something like that.
This one, three.
Yeah.
Good for. Yeah, but with the fox, yeah, it's talking. You're talking three.
$3,000. Yeah. Oh well. £3,000. Pretty good. I bet it's super lightweight.
Oh, it's been bled. Yeah.
Malc,
is it?
Pick that up, mate. There's nothing there, is there?
Made of feathers.
For a mountain bike, it looks solid and it don't weigh nothing.
We've had this before, it's a bit tall, bugger.
Yeah, tall. Cool. Here's the land in which we live. That's where we're going. Up there.
No, this is absolutely brilliant.
Hi, Jack. Whoops.
We're walking, what, half an hour?
Not far.
Not far, but
yeah.
Absolutely superb.
Thank goodness for the outdoors, we were saying.
And Rwandan coffee.
And Rwandan coffee. Well, we're heading up towards Hay Bluff. Malcolm and I are going to find a pitch just below the bluff. Beautiful part of, could I say, English-Welsh border, I would say. Hay on Wye, the Mountain Knowledge Centre, we call it, is not far behind us.
It's just a distant memory.
What we're on the Capelly Finn Road, which leads up to Gospel Pass, which is the second highest pass in Wales. Fantastic views up there. That's actually where we're heading now. But you can drive up there, and it's a very popular driving spot. And eventually you'll drive through, it'll take you through the Vale of Uist, which is absolutely gorgeous. We just heard a nuthatch, but it disappeared, huh?
Still calling, but...
Yeah, it's him. People coming down. Right, this is us, this, Malc.
Is it? Right,
yeah,
okay.
I'll go. I don't mind. Whoop. Whoop. Hope you don't mind the camera, guys. How you doing?
Okay, fine. So where are you going?
So at the top.
So why are you going?
Below the fan.
Yeah.
Find a pitch, and then walk down Dulas Brook.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
That should be nice.
That should be all right.
Well, we've just been up there.
Yeah.
Nice afternoon.
Is it? Good.
I know, modern technology.
I know, it's disgusting, isn't it?
You know.
So what are you going
to
do?
It's the only luxury I have, I think.
It is?
Yeah. Because I don't drive and I don't do all that thing. And
so you just carry that around.
I just film
a
lot.
Yeah.
Well, I try not to annoy people. You know, I know people are sensitive and I know their sensibilities and all. Sometimes they go, oh, no thanks. I go, all right then, no worries.
So what are you doing with the footage?
Well, I put it on a channel called Wye Explorer.
Okay.
Which is basically exploring the River Wye.
Okay.
Walking all the tributaries and finding the sources and documenting them. But this time I'm out with a friend just to get at the top there and...
Yeah. Yeah.
Have a night out and test some gear out. And
well, we live in Hay. Go up to the top twice a week.
Right.
Do you put it on YouTube or your website?
I do. I'll write it down if you can check it out if you want. It's all free will. Wye Explorer.
Okay.
There's a website too.
Yeah.
Okay. We've documented most of the sources and which has been absolutely fantastic. And
so walkers and people access it and get ideas for themselves.
You can get ideas from it. In actual fact, I'm not a web designer. I've done my best. It's a beautiful website, visually, and there are articles about the walks and the hikes we've done of these rivers. But I'm getting better at putting information on there. I often forget and don't quite understand what people are looking for.
Yeah.
But I'm getting there. I'm learning more as I go along.
Okay. Explore
it? I think you'll enjoy it.
Yeah, no, we're good.
Yeah. What's your name, guys?
My name's Michael.
Michael.
Steve.
Michael and Steve. And that's Malcolm.
Malc, how you doing?
Yeah. And I'm Mark.
Okay.
Nice.
All right.
Right. 24 miles a week and you'll be fine.
Shake your hand, sir.
That's a bit, mate.
Shake your hand, sir.
Enjoy your walk.
That's a bit, mate. Yeah.
Take care, guys.
Take care.
Easy. Good meeting.
Absolutely, yeah.
Some local folks.
Yeah. They seemed a little bit suspicious at first, didn't they? What are you filming me?
It's the camera.
Yeah.
It's the camera. That was good. Enjoyed that. Keep going, Malc. No. Yeah, man. It's beautiful. The wood store. That's the coolest wood store I've ever seen. Oh wow, we got more. Well, unfortunately for you, you're probably dinner. and I are approaching the bluff now. It's just up through here. It's going to be misty, it's going to be cloudy. Usually you can see the western escarpment of the Black Mountains, but not today. Well, we don't know, we'll have to wait and see, won't we? It might be quite dramatic, what with the mist, Malc.
Very much so, hopefully.
You know.
Nice shot just here.
Oh, carry on, mate. There's Hay Bluff. In the mist. You can't see much. But that is... well, this is where we're camping tonight. But Malc and I think these are ideal conditions.
Absolutely.
There aren't many people that would agree with us in the world, but we like it.
We know we're right.
We know we're right, yeah, definitely. Yeah, bathed in mist, lovely.
What course that hill there?
Not sure, Malc. Stuff. Yeah, we're not climbing it, guys. What we're doing is we're going to find a place to pitch up for the night, wake up in the morning and traverse round and come back down what's called Dulas Brook, which is a heavily wooded mixed woodland valley which leads all the way into Hay on Wye. But it's full of waterfalls, myth and legend, I would imagine. So that's the plan, but the Hay Bluff is looking great. It's looking
spectacular.
Spectacular. Misty and magical. Another sheep that's been strangled in the fence and couldn't get back out. I'll just orientate you just for a moment. Over there is Tymphony Hill, which is the source of the River Mono. Here is Hay Bluff. Right there. You can't see it, it's in cloud. So we need to be out of the wind. We're gonna drop down into this gully. What's gonna happen? This is gonna be waist high, this bracken.
Yeah.
And if I can avoid it, I will. because otherwise
we're going to get soaked.
So what do you reckon, Malc?
I reckon we should stay here and look at the view.
Stay here. Yeah, stay here and look at the view. I was going to drop down.
Right.
Drop down in there somewhere. Find, there's a flat spot in there somewhere.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Flat spot. Minus bracken, or bracken in the flat spot.
Oh, it'll be minus the bracken.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Grazed, if you like.
All right.
Stealth camping, and you have to find your place. We do not know where we're going to end up, but we will find a nice little flat spot to tuck into. Okay, looks like we're going to get wet anyway.
This is what you call living, folks.
It is living.
Absolutely beautiful.
Living the life.
Oh yeah, this is living. I'm not going down the pub getting pissed.
No.
I'm not staying in watching EastEnders.
No.
Not watching the football.
Best entertainment out here.
And it's free.
Well, the only thing that we have to pay for is our energy, and that's it.
Well, that's it.
Fuck, man, look how deep all this shit is, man. Bloody jungle. We need to be getting down there. Believe it, but that is Herefordshire. If only this were flat, we'd have an ideal camp spot, wouldn't we, Malc?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't make it for that.
But it ain't flat, and we've got to get down this valley. Get down into the flat spot. Because it's too windy up top.
That's beautiful.
Hey, we've got a trail.
Whoa, oh yeah, sheep trail.
We have a trail, which can be helpful.
Oh yeah.
We have a fence line, have an old gate. Oh, I love these old gates. I know it sounds very, very dorky and stuff, but
friendly could talk, I always think.
I know. Check out that handle, man.
Wow.
I know it seems a geeky thing to say, but I can just imagine the old boy farmer opening this.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Letting Jesse the sheepdog out.
Yeah. Well, we've chosen the wild way. The brook is down there. It's not going to be deep, we know that. There's not much water about. This is where we are, guys. Malc and I have chosen to come off piste, as it were.
And go wild.
Yeah, and go wild, yeah. You can see how deep it is down there. On the other side is a flat spot. That's where we're heading for. So, let's go, Malc. I'm not going on my ass, so I'm going steady. Nice and steady as you go over that fence, Malc.
Of course, in hiking. I love the easy routes.
Yeah. We're in a jungle. That's why we've chosen the jungle. Wow, man. We found an old homestead or something. Yeah. Now that's what happens when you come off piste, isn't it? You find old stuff. Yeah, you only come across this stuff if you get off the beaten track. So, I don't want to rely on that too much, it might be rotten. Hey, yeah, Mal. Right. Bye. What do you think this was? There's a fireplace and everything, man. Well, no, not really. Look at this fireplace. Who?
Oh, wow.
Who had a house or a home here? Look at that lintel there. You see that lintel? Just there.
That's amazing.
Wow. I mean, who could possibly want to live here? I mean, it's right.
Me.
Yeah. Well, what I mean is, it's right. There's no flat spot, so to speak. Here's an old lintel here, still here. It's old.
See, people lived their lives here.
They did live their lives
now
here.
It's just a derelict shell. It's amazing. It's well hidden away, isn't it?
How old do you think? Well, when was it abandoned? 1930s? This has been falling down.
Probably
a long...
at least, yeah, yeah. Because yeah. I mean, the walls are solid, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're properly built.
It's been falling down a long time though, isn't it?
Yeah.
I presume.
That's amazing.
Assume there's a track there somewhere. Being this, being it is awesome. How did these people get in here? Because this is deep in a gully, man. Yeah, how'd they get in here? Well, we gotta go down. We gotta get to the brook.
And that tree's been growing out there for a good few years, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That's cool. I'm gonna get shot at that.
All right, brook. Yeah. We're still heading down into the gully, the valley. Awesome little house though. I can hear the brook, it's down there.
Yeah, I'm there, you know.
I think we might need a stick just to steady ourselves. Do you know what this reminds me of?
Grizzly Adams?
No, it reminds me of True Grit. Yeah. When it echoes in the wood, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're coming back with me, Tom Chaney. Brilliant, like, love it.
God, that's just untouched, isn't it?
Oh yeah, this is the wild part of the Hay Bluff, isn't it?
Very much so. Yeah.
This is the mountainside, isn't it? This is what it's made up of. This is why I like getting into these places.
Yeah, yeah, little hidden gems.
Yeah. All right, let's go in it.
That's a lovely little bit of peaceful forest.
Yeah. I can hear the brook.
Yeah, mate.
So we're close. We need to get on the other side. Okay, we've done it the hard way. We got staffs. Staffs. Yeah. And they're just to steady us as we go down there. Because it's quite thick. Like that.
Injured. That was only the first thing you see going in.
Well, that was the stone, man.
Is it?
Yeah. There's no rush getting down here.
World hiking.
Wild hiking.
Wild styling.
Yeah, man. Right, so I can still hear the brook.
Yeah.
Not far away. It's right down there, the brook.
Vegetation's getting a bit less as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. We've just come through that lot.
Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, this is great being here.
Oh, yeah.
This is spot on, Malc.
This is boy corner territory.
Yeah, man. You look as though you're at home, mate.
I am.
Yeah, we're here to experience a different part of the Hay Bluff. This is the foot of the Hay Bluff. And it's full of steep ravines and gullies, and this is great. This is what we come out for, really, Malc, isn't it?
This is living.
Yeah.
This is absolutely awesome.
All right, guys, we are heading down, and a quick shout out. I'm sure Malcolm would agree with me. A quick shout out to Chris Lone Wolf. That's true enough, Malcolm, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Hello, Chris. How you doing, mate? Thumbs up.
We did think about him, didn't we?
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. He'd have loved it here, mate.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
We did think about you, Chris, but it was short notice.
Spur of the moment. Really.
Spur of the moment. Hopefully, we'll do another one. And I was saying to Malcolm that you are very much at home in the Black Mountains, and that's very true.
Yeah, no, I love the Black Mountains.
Yeah, man.
As Chris knows.
Yeah. We're in a different part of the Black Mountains. Not many people come down here.
This is tourist-free zone.
It's tourist-free zone.
Best zone.
Yeah. Right, we're heading down, and then we're heading for this flat spot, which is supposedly on the map. All right. Cheers, guys. Just how thick is that earth, Malc?
Tell you what, Mark, this is amazing compost.
Yeah.
It's just so loose.
It's just
great to scramble down, but...
Years of decomposition, bro, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. That's the start of life.
Yeah. That's going to feed other life.
Absolutely, yeah. Nutrients in the ground.
Yeah.
Feeds things that fly in the sky.
Yeah, absolutely. And so on and so forth.
And then they come down from the sky to feed on things in the ground.
Yeah.
Big circle of life.
Sure, man.
Invertebrates, mammals.
Yeah.
Plants, flora, fauna, amazing.
And us too.
And us too, yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm not going to eat it.
No, but eventually that circle of life reaches us.
Absolutely.
We're part of it.
Yeah, yeah. It's just such a fertile soil.
It is.
It's just amazing.
Let's have a look at it, close up, bro. Look at that.
That's so loose.
That's thick.
I've done nothing to that, just picked it up.
This forest woodland hasn't been touched in years. It's just been left alone, isn't it?
It's a completely natural ecosystem.
Yeah, it's just been left alone.
It's nice to see. You don't see many natural ecosystems in England anymore. But this is by far absolutely beautiful.
And it's a mixed woodland. It's not just pine or that's spruce. Right, yeah. There's some broadleaf in here as well, isn't there?
Yeah, there is, yeah.
Well, there we go. We've reached the bottom. That's the, I think it's pronounced the Esquin Brook. Which feeds into the Dulas Brook.
Oh wow.
Amazing. Which ultimately feeds into the River Wye. So all this is Wye waters, River Wye waters, all this. Immense. Comes from everywhere, doesn't it?
So warm.
It is warm.
Do what I do, if you're too hot, get the bandana, wet right. It, keeps wet for ages.
Yeah, pretty cool. This is Malcolm in the jungle. This is like a temperate rainforest.
Yeah, very much.
That's what it reminds me of. Because I suspect there are mosses and all sorts here which you can't find elsewhere.
Wow, that's refreshing.
Yeah, it reminds me of temperate woodland, temperate rainforest. Wonderful, that was a great hike. All the way up there. Ha! Up there.
Water's so refreshing.
I'll have a go on that water in a minute, Malc.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I recommend it.
Right, gonna crack on, have a go on this water. This is what we climbed for. Oh man, that tastes. It's awesome. That is awesome. That's it, that's nice and clear. Really tastes nice.
Oh god, yeah.
Wonderful, isn't it? That's what. Yeah. That's taken the whole mountain to just clean it up.
That's fantastic. Who needs Evian? That's what I say.
Well, yeah, yeah. Do you know what Evian is backwards? Think about it.
Naive.
Naive.
Naive, yeah.
And a good old friend of mine, Steve Manning, told me that. Very true. Made it out of there.
Oh wow. What a different view.
Yeah.
Out of the jungle, into the plain.
Out of that jungle.
Onto the savannah.
Yeah. Good stuff. Brilliant.
Wow.
That was enjoyable. That was really, that was
nice.
Really, really enjoyable.
Adventure, that
was. Yeah. Still got to find this spot to pitch our tents. Brilliant. Okay, guys. Bye.
If you get that shot, you've got to earn it by hiking it.
Check out the view.
Beautiful.
You don't see that if you stick on the mainstream bluff trails.
No.
Down there is the Dulas Brook. That is England and Wales you're looking at, folks. If you can hear me. Well, I've got to talk now. I mean, I've seen reviews of guys using this on the trails in the States and people using it in the Pyrenees, and it's held up for 20 odd days. This one guy does a brilliant review. Yeah,
that's alright, it is.
Okay, Malc, isn't it?
It's nice, yeah.
You pitched alright, didn't you?
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah. Got a nice view in the morning.
Yeah, perfect.
Over there. Well, that was good. I think I'll need a little practice with this Six Moon Designs Lunar Solo tent. But I think once I've got it down, once I've got it nailed as such, I think it'll be quite an enjoyable tent. We'll have a look at it in the morning and see how it feels. All right. So what happens is that this front vestibule is held tight by a prussic knot just here, and it seems to work well. All designed to be minimal, basically. So yeah, I'm pretty chuffed with that. Let's go and have a look at Malcolm's setup. Oh, so he's comfortable, look. Which is great. It was a nice flat spot then, Malc.
It was, very much so, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful.
Got your mat down.
Yeah. That down sleeping bag.
Yeah. There's sitting up room in there, is there?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, me and the missus had to use this last year because of the tent.
Oh, you used it as a double?
Well, so me and the missus and the little dog were in there last year.
Oh, really?
It was a tight squeeze.
That was tight.
But for one person, like tonight, me, yeah, equipment, fantastic
that's,
tent.
That's luxury, mate.
Fancy 200. I got it for about 75 quid at Decathlon.
Yeah, right.
Decathlon do a copy of one.
Yeah.
I think it's called Forza, but it's a bit heavier.
Right.
It's less of a hydrostatic head.
Right.
That's 5,000.
That's
5,000. It's a little tent.
That'll do though in heavy rain. That'll
be
alright.
Yeah. It's been blasted on for 3 days solid in Devon last year. Not a drop got in.
Oh, right.
It's a cracking tent. I love it.
Yeah.
I've got a lot of Vango tents though, to be honest.
Yeah.
Oh yes, we're cooking.
Ah, here we go. Wow, look at that for a rolling boil.
Fantastic, that. Run on boil ethanol.
I'll have one or two of those, you see. Mark, I'll just... It's just for taste, really. I always have a small little thing.
Yeah? Yeah. There you go.
Cheers to you, bro.
More coffee, mate, if you need it.
Yep.
Very pleasant taste of coffee.
Of course.
Yeah,
that's nice.
That Rwanda coffee earlier, though. That Rwanda coffee.
That was nice. That was fruity and...
Absolutely perfect. Yeah. Love that one. Get a red light there. I'm going back to the car tomorrow. I might have to purchase another cafetiere of that, you know.
Oh, you reckon?
Just to be traditional.
Oh. Successful day, I would say.
I wonder if people want to live in houses when you've got a tent.
Wonderful, wonderful afternoon, right?
Oh, fantastic.
And evening.
Yeah, that scramble from down a hill.
Mm.
Awesome.
Scrambling for a fair bit because
oh,
it goes through the bracken.
Yeah. Wild hiking.
That's great, always go off piste.
Yeah, yeah.
Got to, ain't you?
Yeah. Nice going where no one else has been or not many people have been before.
Yeah, that's right.
Off the beaten track, as I say. Oh, yeah.
My couscous is ready.
Never had that, I must admit.
Put some cocktail sausages in it.
As a bit of a filler.
Yeah, a bit of a filler. Mm. It's just kind of minimal camping, really. The couscous is lightweight, doesn't weigh anything hardly.
Yeah.
Put a bit of chilli in it, and we're good to go. That's nice.
It doesn't weigh much once the cans are empty.
Do you put them together?
Yeah.
You put the together, beans warm with the steak and stew.
Oh God, yeah.
So that's
outdoors.
Tomato.
This is baked beans and pork sausages in tomato sauce with stewed steak, and believe me, it goes together beautifully.
Pork and steak going together well. Well, I've never heard that one.
If you was in your house and mixed it, made it, it'd probably taste like crap. Yeah, but outdoors, it tastes perfect.
Well, we can eat anything.
Absolutely.
Practically.
Protein.
Yeah.
I bought it myself for my birthday. Mrs. went on a brownie camping trip.
It.
Yeah.
Right.
And on my birthday, and she left me. So as I was sobbing away, all on my own on my birthday.
And where were you?
I was at home. between shifts.
Oh, I see, right.
Off the internet, I thought, sod it. Only about a tenner.
Right.
But I just like the Anglo arms.
Yeah, you wear the Anglo arms, they're pretty good, mine,
they
for
are,
the
yeah,
price.
Yeah. Cracking bit of kit. I needed a bit of clean. I used it on holiday last week.
What's the edge like on it? Is it
sharp?
Is it
I
sharp?
Sharpened it the day, yeah, yeah.
Right.
It was quite sharp out of the box, but I sharpened it with the old Lansky blade.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
But yes, Mrs. cut herself. She was cutting some onions with it last week and cut herself.
Oh.
And she hardly touched herself with it.
But nice little tool, man.
Yeah, it is, yeah. I mean,
yeah,
so it's a little weight.
Yeah, that's...
It's a nice weight.
That's a good weight. Sturdy, isn't it?
It's very, yeah, it's full tang as well. Full tang. And it's a nice little looking sheath. Whether it lasts or not, I don't know, but...
Nice blade on it.
I like the look of the sheath and that, but yeah. It's called a Desert Master. Sure, it's the Desert Master.
Nice that, Mel.
Yeah.
You get good use out of it?
Yeah, yeah, use it quite a bit, yeah, when I'm out in the forest and that, yeah, thank you.
Nice one, man.
Nice.
See the inside of the tent being blown inwards there, pushing inwards in strong wind. That's the only gripe I've got. I'll just say that the carbon fibre pole fits up inside there into a nice neat little pocket. There's reinforced material up there, and the carbon fibre pole just fits into a nice little pocket. And into there. So you only need one pole. And as I said, the geometric nature of the tent holds it all up. Given a little bit of experience with this tent, you could probably put it up in 3 to 4 minutes. So there you go. That's my new tarp tent. Malcolm's up, he's woken up. Good morning, Malcolm.
Good morning. How
are
you doing?
How you doing, bro?
Oh, I wake up to this.
Oh, it's gorgeous, man.
Oh, man.
Here he is. He's come out of his deep sleep.
Oh, yeah. This was... When you wake up to this, you think, I think to myself, why don't I get a mortgage?
Yeah.
Being outdoors.
Wow.
It's like a hobo as opposed to some brick and mortar.
It's a lovely fresh morning.
Slave to the mortgage, it's beautiful, yeah. Fantastic. Oh, what a nice place.
It is. I've checked out the view, really nice.
Is it misty over there? Can't quite see.
Yeah, there's a lot of cloud.
Is there?
Yeah. Potentially a lot of rain, but it's not raining, obviously.
It rained a little bit in the night, didn't it?
It did rain a bit, enough, not a great deal.
How did the tent hold up?
Okay, I've reviewed it.
Yeah.
I have. The only thing that I had a problem with last night was that this blew in.
Oh, did it?
Right? But I've tested out these tension points here, and if I were to use them, and of course I haven't, if I were to use them, they would sort it out.
Yeah.
In all fairness.
It's trial and error, isn't it?
Yeah, in all fairness to them, if I used those guy lines here, it would work.
Yeah, not a problem.
Yeah.
So that's not a tent fault, really, is it?
Not really. It's just that I haven't.
The guy lines.
It's just I haven't used the guy lines. There's loads of space inside.
Is there?
Loads of space. Well, we've been experiencing a few views along the way, and we're walking beside the Dulas Brook towards Hay on Wye. Hay Bluff is up there, and the brook is in there. Oh, there it is, I can see it. We're going to cross the brook again, that's what we're going to do, because the public right of way seems to have disappeared. Kissing the water again, Malcolm.
Yeah, love it.
Yeah.
In love with the water.
Yeah, man.
Well, yeah, you feel the freshness of this.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, Aquarius, aren't I, would say.
Yeah, all right.
That's the reason, isn't it?
Of course.
Fantastic. Awesome play.
Nice one, man. Water cupped in hand, but water from the brook, Dulas Brook. Yeah, willing to take a risk on that water, that tastes beautiful. Of course, all this flows into the River Wye, a couple of miles that way. But this water, well, this has come off the Hay Bluff. It's come off Cusop Hill. I suspect some of it's come off Tymphony Hill as well. Yeah, it's all good stuff.
Hard to get a foothold of this loose rock, isn't it?
Just put it up on that lip there, that's what I did. That's it. Yeah.
That's better.
A lot easier.
Yeah.
Just crawl up in. Yeah, man.
It's okay. Mine is a rucksack.
Doing it the adventure way again.
Oh, I love it. Best way, the only way to do it.
The only way. Right, nice and easy. Been a good day in a bit. Heading towards Hay. Oh, it's a kingfisher.
Yeah, and again.
We just get here and we hear a kingfisher. Oh, look at how beautiful that river looks. far, it was worth walking to the Y, wasn't it?
Yes, definitely.
Well worth it. This was the star, really, if you like. I don't know. It all was. What I mean is it's just that water was flowing into here. So yeah, that's the Eskley Brook flowing, not the Eskley Brook, the Dulas Brook. What am I saying? The Eskley Brook. That's on the other side of the Black Mountains. That's Michael Church. No, the Dulas Brook. Here we are, look. Thank you.